I call out of one. I pray this devil died and get every evil thing the Lord got to give. And listen, I know you look at us in the state we in right now. Come Yahshua. Come Yahshua. Come Yahshua. I know you look at us in the state we in right now. Black people on drugs and we suffering and dying. And I know it seems like you can do whatever you want to this people. I know it seems like this. But the time for glorifying yourself is soon at an end.
One thing that the white man has done since we came into slavery that's benefited black people. Give me one social program. One thing the white man has erected on the earth that's benefited black people. You got your hand up, brother. What you got to say?
Hey, look, they gave y'all that Bible right there.
The white man didn't give us the Bible, brother.
See, I'm thinking so. What version you got?
The Bible didn't get the King James version of the Bible, right, is what we reading out here.
All right, so let's get that straight. King James won the Hebrew.
Black man, King James was a Hebrew.
No, he wasn't. Where? Where's his lineage at? Where's his line?
Brother, if we gonna go into the history records, we can get it for you. But guess what?
Now don't.
Here's what's important.
No, you just bust.
Here's what's important.
Hey, check that
down. King James didn't write this Bible.
I never said.
Okay, I know. I'm correct. I'm helping you out. All King James did was hire scholars to translate what was already written in Hebrew, already written in Greek, and have it translated into English so that everybody would be able to read it. Guess what? I'll tell you something else about King James. He didn't know the truth. He didn't know the white man was the devil. You understand? But he was a tool that the Lord used to make sure that we had the records in the language that we speak today to be able to enlighten our people.
All right, hold on, let me say this. So who did he hire then? Was they white boys or not?
They were not white boys.
Educated in Harvard and Yale, yes they was.
No, they wasn't.
Yes they was.
So you mean to tell me that all Europe was white men?
No.
All the high schools in Europe was established by white men? That what you're saying?
You just switched the conversation.
I didn't switch the conversation. You said the scholars were white men.
I didn't say that. I said the translators, right? They translated the Bible with white boys. We got the pictures. Don't make me go into the stash. We got the pictures.
You just said they was from Harvard and Yale, so they was white boys.
No.
So are you saying that all the schools that was erected in Europe was erected by white boys?
Man, we know damn well they wasn't doing that.
So then hold up.
We talking about the people that translated the Bible, they got their name on record. Right? We know who they are. They got the pictures.
Matthew,
we know who they are.
Let me ask you a question. Did they have cameras in 16? Did they have cameras in 1611?
Did they have what?
Did they have cameras in 1611?
Cameras.
Cameras. Flick, flick. How did they have records of people and what they look like?
You got painters.
Painters, right?
Artisans,
right?
They got the pictures of
them,
right?
If you pulled up a picture of King, I dare you take your phone out right now, Google King James, and pull a picture up. And what does he look like?
He looked like the white boy.
He looked like, hold up. Who painted him to be a white boy?
The artist, man. Hold on.
The artist, hold up. Give me Christ. We're going to go into it. I'm going to let you speak.
All right.
You just said the painters said they was white boys.
Got him.
Hold up. The painter said.
What?
Who did the painter say this was? Who did the painter say this was?
Hey, that's the right Jesus right there.
Who did the painter say this was?
That's Jesus.
They said it was Jesus, right?
That's Jesus.
But if you go in the history book.
That's Jesus.
If you go in the history book and the history record. What was his name? Because your grandmother was a fool.
Hey,
and my grandmother was a fool too. But stick to the topic. Who did they say this man was?
Listen.
Who did they say? I'm asking you a question, brother. Who did they say this man was?
That's Jesus Christ.
They said he was Jesus. Who was he in history though?
Nobody.
Who was he in history?
He your Lord and Savior, not mine.
Who was he in history? This man on this painting.
That man on the page is Jesus Christ.
No, he's not, brother. I'm going to help this brother out because he's been lied to by the white man. He's been lied to by the devil, and he don't know what he's talking about. This man right here is the second son of Pope Alexander VI of Rome. His name was Caesar Borgia. His father's name was Rodrigo Borgia. He was a homosexual.
Don't
Leonardo da Vinci.
Don't switch it up.
Don't be crying because you got cut. Hope your man learned how to battle correctly. This man is not Jesus Christ. This is Caesar Borgia, second son of Pope Alexander VI of Rome. Now, why did our grandmothers tell us this was Jesus Christ? Because the white man is the devil the Bible speaks of, which is what we've been saying out here all day.
Hey, bro,
who want to come out here and stop black people from learning that the white man is the devil? Only a fool would want black people not to know the white man is the devil. So, well, guess what? Because we love all black people and we want all black people. entertain the fools for a little while. So, right, baby, what's your next question?
Hey, hold on. My next question was, you never asked
let me say
question.
Something real fast.
Hold on one second.
The brother and I talk about the white man being the devil all day. The brother host speaking, these brothers have been out here for about 20 minutes listening to Officer Soccer War talk about the atrocities that's being done to black people. Talking about the white man killing, it's cops killing brothers every week now. Every couple days, they running them over with cars. And the only question he could come up with is not a solution.
You tell
not
him,
a solution, but to talk about the
you
Bible being
that.
White. And when Soccer War come and bring up the image, he want to talk about imagery. As if we going to trust the white man and his imagery. When you have anything in the Renaissance era, if you know what the Dark Ages was, that's when black people ruled Europe. Give me the archaeology, y'all. Give me the archaeology, the Dark Ages.
Get it straight,
the Dark man. Ages is when black people ruled Europe. You know why? That's why they called it the Dark Ages. And when they started painting them white bitches, that's what they called the Renaissance era. That's why this bastard is white.
That's why
this bastard is white. This bastard is white because you have white painters. Let me tell you something with history. Let me tell y'all something with history. When you have history, history is written by men. So when history is written by men, whoever's the authoritative with that pen, he's gonna make himself the major important part of that story. That's why Jesus is white. But when you go into the Bible, he's not white. Now, these so-called Egyptologists, this is what you have. You have Uncle Keck. This is Uncle Keck from the Amara Squad. Came all the way up here from Atlanta, Georgia, to do some dedication tomorrow against that false prophet, Dr. Ben. He was false too. He was no different. Yeah, don't know why.
Oh,
like
y'all
that.
Hear that?
Don't know
y'all
why.
Hear like that.
Now, let me tell you why. Now, I'll address that in a second. But what was Dr. Ben when he first started? He was a Jew. He got a bar mitzvah like the goddamn white man. Then he switched up to Egyptology. Studied Egyptology. But when he died in a Jewish hospital. Now, if y'all had a dedication for him, why y'all ain't put him in no Egypt hospital? Why did he get buried in a Christian church? He got buried in a Christian church. He didn't get mummified. He was an Egyptologist and was in Egypt. Why did he get mummified? And his records is falsified.
Let him get a chance to speak.
His record ain't got to let nobody do nothing. You want to interrupt my brother talking about the conditions of my people to talk about King James? To talk about King James, whether King James is black or white. You think the white man run up to them? When the white man shoot black people, he don't say, yo, is he an Israelite? Is he a Muslim? Is he in the Quran? Does he believe King James? No. He sees black people and he says, I'm going to kill them. You got what I asked for? Read that part right there. Now, the brother said, the unk said, the pictures of the writers of King James were white people. So of course that makes them white. That's what he said. Here's history. This is the icons of Constantinople. A book, because they swear we don't study. This is the icons of Constantinople. Now remember, he said they was white because the artist painted them white. Read.
Russian icons existed not only as panel paintings, but also as frescoes and wall mosaics. Some of which have emerged from layers of whitewash.
From what?
Whitewash.
From what?
Whitewash.
Because when they painted them, come here, guys, I'm a wall. When they painted them, this is where you see, y'all come up here close, and see what I'm saying. Artistry makes them white. Come up close, don't be afraid. Look at the image of the black people here, and they painting them white. So when you telling me that they're white because of artistry, I can take a painting right now, paint it however I want to say, and say Christ was any goddamn color. It gotta be true according to the Bible. And the Bible says that Jesus Christ was a black man, that his skin was as dark as if he burned in the furnace. Now let me tell you what they're really about. They're really just about a distraction. That's all. They not really out here because he ain't got no solution for black people. Is the white man the devil? Is the white man the devil?
Let me handle this.
Is the white man the devil?
Hell yeah! And if black people don't know that the white man is the devil in 2015, come on, black man. We all know that the white man is the devil.
Why are you answering for? Is the white man the devil?
First of all, I'm a real black atheist, so I don't deal with God or the devil.
No sweat.
But let me tell you
something.
I deal with human beings. I deal with human beings.
This is the problem. The word devil just means
I deal with human actions.
Now, the fact that...
So they call him that.
Say that again, brother.
Call him back.
Say that again.
Call him
why
back
are you here?
Say it again, brother.
Why are you here?
I ain't here to talk to you.
Now, that's the crowd. That's the people. That's the people.
He here. He are here to teach Negroes like you that don't know, that don't have a knowledge of self. That's why the hell we here. We here to teach Negroes like you. That's why we here.
No sweat, I got you.
That's why the hell we here.
And y'all remember, he just said that he's a real black atheist.
Why the hell your ass here?
He said he's a real black atheist. And let me tell you something. You see that? That gets under their skin. Because they know they ain't here for black people. They here for entertainment. So I know they ain't got no reason to say nothing. I'm talking to Uncle Tech.
You won't let me talk. That's a bullshit conversation right there, bro.
He said he don't believe in no God. He said he don't believe in nothing. Let's get Uncle Tech's own words on what he believe in and what he don't believe in. Since he say he don't believe in that, let's get his own words on what he believe in.
Real African.
This is what he said.
System. How many niggas ever did a real sacrifice with a knife and acted with the life of another creature?
This is him.
People did that.
This is him. Listen what he said. Let me bring it back. Let me bring it back now. Remember, just remember, he said that he don't believe in no God. That he's an atheist. Now, he gonna say who did a real sacrifice of voodoo. He gonna say how he had an altar, but he don't believe in no God. We gonna play it again. I'm gonna play it again.
Run that back. Run that beautiful man for this one more time, baby.
And a real initiated voodoo judoo system. How many niggas ever did a real sacrifice with a knife and actually took the life of another creature? How many people did that? Listen it. Because I am. How many people have an altar? I'm looking at my altar right now.
And this house, he got an altar.
And I'm looking at my dick.
But he don't worship nothing. And he's looking at his deity. But he going to tell us, he going to tell us that he don't worship no God. But he do worship a God. The name of that God is Pest. He worships some nasty, filthy, Egyptian God by the name of Pest. Now, let me tell you how Pest is not a God. This nigga, did you get a pass?
I'm not asking any questions.
Did you get your pass? Did you get your pass to come to New York City? Did you get your pass? Because the Muslims are going to whip your ass if you can't get your clearance. Now, who saved them? Y'all want to know who saved them?
Yo, man.
Best did not save
them. And don't fuck them.
God Best did not save them. You know who saved them? The God of Israel. The brother Hashar from AOC made sure that this brother could make it live in New York City. And to show his appreciation for Hashar, he going to come up here and try to trash the Bible?
Right.
When the God of Israel is the reason why he can walk in New York right now. The Muslim is going to whip his ass. He was scared to death. He was scared to goddamn death. And Hashar from AOC saved this man's life because our God is real. How come Best didn't save you?
You gonna let me talk? Can I talk?
How come Best didn't save you? I'm asking a question. How come Best didn't save you?
Let's just establish.
How come Best didn't save you?
What he's doing is called deferring.
It's not the
first.
I cut him with you. The first question you said was that the translators was white because of the pictures. I showed you in the old Renaissance books that you were goddamn lying. I showed it to you. I showed it to you. Your only proof was pictures. That's your proof.
See how they doing.
Give me proof other than pictures.
You played that clip, right?
That's correct.
And I made my
And how did that God save you?
Because
you don't believe in no God.
Let me finish.
You don't believe in no God.
Let me finish.
Right, but it's an altar.
You can't be a cut-off. You can't be a cut-off artist. Let's have this.
Come on.
First of all, African people didn't worship God.
They did worship
God. They worshiped the forces of nature.
They did
get
worship
that shit
God.
Straight.
Yeah.
No, they worshiped the forces of nature, nigga.
And the natures that they follow, give me hey.
Yo, y'all keep cutting them off, man. I'm sorry, y'all keep cutting them off. You said you was going to let them talk.
I can hear them.
Y'all cutting them off.
I can hear them.
You running scared. Let the people hear the discourse.
Let them hear the discourse.
No, not the
first goddamn time.
Because he said that.
Right here. Let somebody else talk. We hear you all damn day. Let me make my point. Here's my point. Ask the people honored the natural world around them.
Right. And the natural world.
Not till they got that goddamn Bible.
The natural world that they honored
let's get that shit
was
straight.
Men that have penises aimed at their mouth.
Okay,
that's the man that they honored. Yes, pass that around. Now pass that around, sister. That's the men that they honored. The natures that they honored pointed words in their mouth because, let me tell you something, Jonathan from the Amara squad, who's in his organization, said that the Egyptians believe that you can get pregnant in the goddamn mouth. You know why? Because the gods that they follow believe you can come in, you can bust in your mouth and spit forth creation.
You know you got them arrows coming.
Answer it.
All right, stay tuned.
And to show you how the Africans do it today, this is what they do today. This is what Africans do today. Now, how many of y'all gonna follow these niggas? How many of y'all gonna follow them? Huh? Huh? That don't fuck. Listen, that's a wooden, my bad. Let me make sure you get it right. That is a wooden rod that they strap on themselves and aim at another man's butt in Africa. And you told me you got the power. So now, where the best savior? Where the best savior? What best savior?
You gonna claim after claim after claim after claim. I wouldn't do you like that.
I wouldn't do you like that.
I wouldn't do you
because
like that.
Because you in my house, stopping me from my business, so I can talk about who wrote the Bible. Give me the Egyptian solution for black people. Give it to me.
Get the fuck away from that Bible. Last 500 years we've been in America, we've been dealing with that Bible.
Right.
At some point, we need to figure out, well, shit ain't changing. The sky ain't gonna crack like y'all say.
Right.
Tell these people what you think. The sky gonna crash and the army gonna crack. What type of shit is that in 2015? Don't Google that shit.
Right.
It don't make no
sense. That's real easy.
That's not real. No, don't talk. Let me talk. I'm trying to tell you solutions.
Yeah, give me the Egyptian solution.
Start sticking the goddamn together.
Give me the Egyptian.
You keep talking. First of all, we're going to take off them biker outfits because it's hot as a motherfucker up here.
Right.
That's the first thing.
Exactly.
If you live in Palestine, that goddamn sand would slow your ass down.
Yeah.
Let's get all that sand. So the solution is that we put our money together. Because money talks. That bullshit walks.
Money ain't gonna save black people. I asked him for the Egyptian solution. I didn't ask him for his own personal solution. I didn't ask you for your own personal solution.
I
asked you the Egyptian said money. Egyptian said money.
Egyptian said resources, brother. It's about the resources.
No, they're not.
It's about securing resources. I'm saying their whole culture was based off.
Give me the Egyptian records.
I am telling you.
Give me the quote. Give me a verse. Give me a chapter. Open up the bag. Give me the book out of there. Like, I got my Bible. Now, the only thing he said that was right, I'm going to cut him off now because he ain't saying shit.
The only thing that he said was right was that we had that Bible in our hands for 500 years.
He's right that we had that Bible for 500 years. He's correct. Now, the problem is we didn't have an understanding of the Bible. That's the problem. Now, if you want to tell me that the Bible is the problem, then I would have to go into the Bible and find where there's love for white people in this book.
First of all, prove that the Bible. Hold on. Everybody listening right now, I want you to prove to the crowd that that's the Bible. Go ahead, son.
What you mean, prove this the Bible?
Prove that's the Bible. Because I don't fucking believe it.
I said prove that it's the Bible. Okay, now, in order to prove that this is the Bible, right, we're going to have to find where it comes from. Meaning, if I want to, that's a lie. If I want to prove Egyptian hieroglyphics from an English book, I can't just use the English book. I have to compare it to the Hebrew, excuse me, to the Egyptian records, so that when I read the English breakdown, it correlates with the Egyptian records. So I'm calling for the Tanakh. So when I read the King James, it correlates right with the Hebrew. So you asking a question, but you don't want the answer.
All right, let me give you an answer. First of all, right, no one has ever read the Bible. There's no original manuscript, no facsimiles, no direct copies from the original.
That's a
so
lie.
No nigga in America,
that's a lie.
Nobody has ever read the Bible.
That's
it
a
was
lie.
Some scrolls,
that's a
there
lie.
Was no chapters, right. No verses. We got this trickology right there.
It's not trickology.
Don't stand out here high on the screen
that's
like
not
that.
Trickology.
Ain't nobody ever read the Bible.
I'm still waiting for your Egyptian record solution.
I don't got it. First
you don't got one.
Change it over yet.
I know you ain't got one.
You want to be top? Can I give you a solution?
I want the Egyptian solution, not your personal solution.
Hold on. First of all, he keeps saying Egyptian solution. First of all, black people predate goddamn Egypt.
Okay.
You want
so give me the African solution. Give me the African solution then.
The ancient African solution. The goddamn African solution has been from time immemorial.
Okay, which is what?
Food, clothing, and goddamn shelter.
Now, where is that written?
The protection of your food, clothing, shelter. Yeah.
Now, how's that working for Africa right now?
How's working? Niggas ain't securing their food, clothing,
food resources. How is that working for Africa right now?
It ain't working because niggas ain't. ain't doing
the mother of flies. You know how they call Africa the motherland? Africa is the mother of flies right now. You know what they doing in Africa? They eating each other in Africa. Go YouTube General Butt Naked. Go YouTube him. Not only are they eating each other and out there, they sowing their babies for tours. Y'all don't believe each other? Where's my favorite part? Y'all know my favorite part. I love to go to this joint. This is what they do in Africa. Now, who's doing this in Africa? This is their real culture in Africa. They selling their babies, Clint. Look at this woman right here. That's a Clint sold up. Now, who's doing that? Look at this one right here playing with a rod. Now, who's doing that? Look at them, licking that cow's ass as if the cure for diabetes is in that cow's ass. Look at them. Now, how does that correlate to saving black people? I still ain't got no record from you. Now, he wanna say that the Bible is wrong. I don't have a problem.
That's nasty.
I don't have a problem with you saying the Bible is wrong. But give me your solution. If we gotta throw the Bible down, give me your solution.
The whole world gonna be watching.
Give me your solution.
Listen, man.
I'm asking you real simple.
It's real simple. First of all, let me talk. I ain't emotional. I ain't cried yet when y'all talk.
I ain't cried when Sonetta had to answer the white man is the devil because you afraid to say the white man is the devil.
Hey. Well, nowadays I work hard on the job till I come cross y'all. Still like I'm a criminal. Trying to get caught, it could be your first charge. Black man, you ain't getting the minimum. It gon' dip, squat. My manhood. Hey, black women, y'all got to wake the fuck up. Cause some of y'all heavy crackers keep us fucked up. You want your respect, boo, that's what's up.
That's the man that they honor. Yeah, pass that around. Now pass that around, sister. That's the men that they honor. The natures that they honor pointed words in their mouth. Because let me tell you something. Jonathan from the Honor Squad, who's in his organization, said that the Egyptians believe that you can get pregnant in the goddamn mouth. You know why? Because the gods that they follow believe you can come in, you can bust in your mouth and spit forth creation.
You know you got them arrows coming.
Answer it.
All right, stay tuned.
And to show you how Africans doing today, this is what they do today. This is what Africans do today. Now, how many of y'all gonna follow these niggas? How many of y'all gonna follow them? Huh? Y'all gonna follow, listen, that's a wooden, my bad. Let me make sure you get it right. That is a wooden rod that they strap on themselves and aim at another man's butt in Africa. So you tell me you gotta follow that? So now, where did best save you? Where did best save you? What best save you?
You gonna claim after claim. I wouldn't do you like that.
I wouldn't do you like that.
I wouldn't do you
because
like that.
Because you in my house, stopping me from my business.
I'm not stopping you. So I can talk about
who wrote the Bible. Give me the Egyptian solution for black people. Give it to me.
Get the fuck away from that Bible. Last 500 years we've been in America, we've been dealing with that Bible.
Right.
At some point, we need to figure out, well, shit ain't changing. The sky ain't gonna crack like y'all say.
Right.
Tell these people what you think. The sky gonna crack.
The sky is gonna crack.
What type of shit is that?
Let me ask you,
go Google that shit. That don't make no sense. Don't talk. Let me talk. I'm trying to tell you the solution.
Yeah, give me the Egyptian solution.
Give me the Egyptian. You keep talking.
Go ahead.
First of all, we're going to take off them biker outfits because it's hot as a motherfucker up here.
Right.
That's the first thing.
Now,
if you live in Palestine, that goddamn sand would slow your ass down.
Let's get all that. So the solution is
that we put our money together. Because money talks. That bullshit
works. Whitney Houston died a drug addict. Michael Jackson died a junkie. Money ain't going to save black people. I asked him for the Egyptian solution. I didn't ask him for his own personal solution. I didn't ask you for your own personal solution.
I
asked you the Egyptian say money.
Egyptians said resources, brother. It's about the resources.
No, they're not.
It's about securing resources. I'm saying their whole culture was based off.
Give me the Egyptian records.
I am telling you.
Give me the quote. Give me a verse. Give me a chapter. Open up the bag. Give me the book out of there. Like, I got my Bible. Now, the only thing he said that was right, I'm going to cut him off now because he ain't saying shit.
We had that Bible in our hands for 500 years. He's right. He's correct.
Now, the problem is, we didn't have an understanding of the Bible. That's the problem. Now, if you're going to tell me that the Bible is the problem, then I would have to go into the Bible and find where there's love for white people in this book.
First of all, prove that's the Bible. Hold on. Everybody listening right now, I want you to prove to the crowd that that's the Bible. Go ahead, son.
What you mean, prove this the Bible?
Prove that's the Bible. Because I don't fucking believe it.
Hey, open
I think
up,
it's just a book printed by some white man.
I don't
think that's the Bible.
I got the Tanakh. I'll do you one better.
Yo, go get
but like the goddamn white man.
Hey, yo.
Then he switched up to Egyptology. Studied Egyptology. But when he died in a Jewish hospital. Now, if y'all had a dedication for him, why y'all ain't put him in no Egypt hospital? Why did he get buried in a Christian church? He got buried in a Christian church. He didn't get mummified.
He was in Egypt,
and his records is falsified.
Let him get a chance to speak.
His record ain't gotta let nobody do nothing. You wanna interrupt my brother talking about the conditions of my people to talk about King James? To talk about King James, whether King James is black or white. You think the white man run up to them? When the white man shoot black people, he don't say, yo, is he an Israelite? Is he a Muslim? Is he in the Quran? Does he believe King James? No. He sees black people and he says, I'm going to kill them. You got what I asked for? Read that part right there. Now, the brother said, the unk said, the pictures of the writers of King James were white people. So, of course, that makes them white. That's what he said. Here's history. This is the Icons of Constantinople. A book, because they swear we don't study. This is the Icons of Constantinople. Now, remember, he said they was white because the artist painted them white.
Read.
Icons existed not only as panel paintings, but also as frescoes and wall mosaics. Some of which have emerged from layers of whitewash.
From what?
Whitewash.
From what?
Whitewash.
Because when they painted them, come here, I'm sorry, wall. When they painted them, this is where you see, y'all come up here close and see what say artistry makes them white. Come up close, don't be afraid. Look at the image of the black people here and they painting them white. So when you telling me that they're white because of artistry, I can take a painting right now, paint it however I want to say, and say Christ was any goddamn color. It got to be true according to the Bible. And the Bible says that Jesus Christ was a black man, that his skin was as dark as if he burned in the furnace. Now let me tell you what they really about. They really just about a distraction.
That's all.
They not really out here because he ain't got no solution for black people. Is the white man the devil? Is the white man the devil?
Let me handle this.
Is the white man the devil?
Hell yeah! And if black people don't know that the white man is the devil in 2015, come on, black man. We all know that the white man is the devil.
Why are you answering for? Is the white man the devil?
First of all, I'm a real black atheist, so I don't deal with God or the devil.
No sweat.
Let me tell
you something.
I deal with human beings. I deal with human beings.
This is the problem. The word devil just means
I deal with human actions.
Now, the fact that...
Call him that.
Say that again, brother.
Call him that.
Say it again, brother. Why are you here? That's the people. That's the people. We're here. You know who we're here. Like you. That don't know. That don't have a knowledge of self. That's why the hell we here. He just said. That's why the hell we here. No sweat. I got you. That's why the hell we here. And y'all remember, he just said that he's a real black atheist.
Why the hell your ass here?
He said he's a real black atheist. And let me tell you something. You see that? That gets under their skin. Because they know they ain't here for black people. They here for entertainment. So I know they ain't got no reason to say nothing. I'm talking to Uncle Tech.
You won't let me talk.
That's a bullshit conversation right there, bro.
He say he don't believe in nobody.
You ain't let me talk.
He don't believe in nobody.
You overrunning the mic. Hold on, hold on.
Let's get Uncle Tech's own words on what he believe in and what he don't believe in. Since he say he don't believe in that, let's get his own words on what he believe in.
Real African.
This is what he said.
How many niggas ever did a real sacrifice for the life and acted for the life of another creature?
This is him.
People did that.
This is him. Listen what he said. Let me bring it back. Let me bring it back. Now remember, just remember, he said that he don't believe in no God. That he's an atheist. Now, he gonna say who did a real sacrifice of voodoo. He gonna say how he had an altar, but he don't believe in no God. I'm gonna play it again.
Run that back. Run that beautiful thing. Put it one more time, baby.
And a real initiated a voodoo judo system. How many niggas ever did a real sacrifice with a knife and actually took the life of another creature? How many people did that? Listening. Because I am. How many people have an altar? I'm looking at my altar right now.
And this house, he got an altar.
And I'm looking at my deity.
But he don't worship nothing. He's looking at a deity. But he going to tell us that he don't worship no God. But he do worship a God. The name of that God is Pest. He worships some nasty, filthy, Egyptian God by the name of Pest. Now, let me show you how Pest is not a God. This nigga couldn't. Did you get a pass?
I'm not asking any questions.
Did you get your pass to come to New York City? Did you get your pass? Because the Muslims are going to whip your ass if you can get you killed. Now, who saved them? Y'all want to know who saved them?
Yo, man.
Best did not save
them.
Best did not save them. You know who saved them? The God of Israel. The brother Hashar from AOC made sure that this brother could make it live in New York City. And to show his appreciation for Hashar, he going to come up here and try to trash the Bible?
Right.
When the God of Israel is the reason why he can walk in New York right now. The Muslim is going to whip his ass. He was scared to death. He was scared to goddamn death. And Hashar from AOC saved this man's life because our God is real. How come Best didn't save you?
You gonna let me talk? Can I talk?
How come Best didn't save you? I'm asking a question. How come Best didn't save you? How come Best didn't save you?
What he's doing is called deferring.
It's not the
goddamn question.
I cut it with you. The first question you said was that the translators was white because of the pictures. I showed you in the old Renaissance books that you were goddamn lying. I showed it to you. Your only proof was pictures. That's your proof.
See how they doing.
Give me proof other than pictures.
You played that clip, right?
That's correct.
And I made my
And how did that God save you?
Because the African.
Because you don't believe in no God.
Let me finish.
You don't believe in no God.
Let me finish.
Right, but it's an altar.
You can't be a cut off. You can't be a cut off artist. Let's have this.
Come on.
First of all, African people didn't worship God.
They did worship God.
They worshiped the forces of nature.
Get
that shit straight.
Yeah.
No, they worshiped the forces of nature, nigga.
And the natures that they follow, give me hey.
Yo, y'all keep cutting them off, man. I'm sorry, y'all keep cutting them off. I'm sorry, you said you were going to let them talk.
I can hear them. I can hear them.
You running scared. Let the people hear the discourse.
Let them hear the discourse.
No, not the
first goddamn time.
Because he said that.
Right here. Let somebody else talk. We hear you all damn day. Let me make my point. Here's my point. African people honored the natural world around them.
Right. And the natural world
they got that goddamn Bible.
The natural world that they honored.
Let's get that shit
straight. Was men that have penises aimed at their mouth.
Okay.
A car out of walk. I pray this devil died and get every evil thing the Lord got to give. And listen, I know you look at us in the state we in right now. Come your child.
Come
your child.
Come your child.
I know you look at us in the state we in right now. Black people on drugs and we suffering and dying. And I know it seems like you can do whatever you want to this people. I know it seems like this. But the time for glorifying yourself is soon at an end.
One thing that the white man has done since we came into slavery that's benefited black people.
Give me one social program. One thing the white man has erected on the earth that's benefited black people. You got your hand up, brother. What you got to say?
Hey, look, they gave y'all that Bible right there.
The white man didn't give us the Bible, brother.
Yeah, I'm thinking so. What version you got?
The Bible didn't give the King James version of the Bible, right, what we reading out here.
All right, so let's get that straight. King James won the Hebrew.
Black man, King James was a Hebrew.
No, he wasn't. Where's his lineage at? Where's his line?
Brother, if we're going to go into the history records, we can get it for you. But guess what?
Now don't.
Here's what's important. Here's what's important. Hey,
check that down.
King James didn't write this Bible.
I never said
that. Okay, I know. I'm correct. I'm helping you out. All King James did was hire scholars to translate what was already written in Hebrew, already written in Greek, and have it translated into English so that everybody would be able to read it. Guess what? I'll tell you something else about King James. He didn't know the truth. He didn't know the white man was the devil. You understand? But he was a tool that the Lord used to make sure that we had the records in the language that we speak today to be able to enlighten our people.
All right, hold on, let me say this. So who did he hire then? Was they white boys or not?
They were not white boys.
Educated in Harvard and Yale, yes they was.
No, they wasn't.
Yes they was.
So you mean to tell me that all Yale was white men?
No.
All the high schools in Yale was established by white men? That what you're saying?
You just switched the conversation.
I didn't switch the conversation. You said the scholars were white men.
I didn't say that. I said the translators, right? They're translated by white boys. We got the pictures. Don't make me go into the stash. We got the pictures.
You just said they was from Harvard and Yale, so they was white boys.
No.
So are you saying that all the schools that was erected in Europe was erected by white boys?
Maybe though damn well they wasn't doing that.
Hold up.
We talking about the people that translated the Bible, they got their name on record. Right? We know who they are. They got the pictures. We know who they are.
Let me ask you a question. Did they have cameras in 16? Did they have cameras in 1611?
Did they have what?
Did they have cameras in 1611? Cameras, flick.
No.
How did they have records of people and what they look like?
You got painters.
Painters, right?
Artisans,
right?
They got the pictures of them.
Man, if you pulled up a picture of King, I dare you take your phone out right now, Google King James and pull a picture up. And what does he look like?
He looked like the white boy.
Hold up. Who painted him to be a white boy?
The artist, man. Hold on.
Hold up. Give me Christ. We're going to go into it. I'm going to let you speak.
All right.
You just said the painters said they was white boys.
Got him.
Hold up. The painter said.
What?
Who did the painter say this was? Who did the painter say this was?
Hey, that's the right Jesus right there.
Who did the painter say this
Jesus.
Was?
That's Jesus.
They said it was Jesus, right?
That's Jesus.
But if you go in the history book.
That's Jesus.
If you go in the history book and the history record. What was his name? Cause your grandmother was a fool.
Hey, that's your Lord
and my grandmother was a fool too. But stick to the topic. Who did they say this man was?
Listen.
Who did they say? I'm asking you a question, brother. Who did they say this man was?
That's Jesus Christ.
They said he was Jesus. Who was he in history though?
Nobody.
Who was he in history?
He your Lord and Savior, not mine.
Who was he in history? This man on this painting.
That man on the page is Jesus Christ.
No, he's not, brother. I'm going to help this brother out because he's been lied to by the white man. He's been lied to by the devil, and he don't know what he's talking about. This man right here is the second son of Pope Alexander VI of Rome. His name was Caesar Borgia. His father's name was Rodrigo Borgia. He was a homosexual.
Don't switch it up.
Don't be crying because you got cut. Hope your man learned how to battle correctly. This man is not Jesus Christ. This is Caesar Borgia, second son of Pope Alexander VI of Rome. Now, why did our grandmothers tell us this was Jesus Christ? Because the white man is the devil the Bible speaks of, which is what we've been saying out here all day.
Hey, bro,
who want to come out here and stop black people from learning that the white man is the devil? Only a fool would want black people not to know the white man is the devil. So, well, guess what? Because we love all black people and we want all black people to get knowledge, we're going to entertain the fools for a little while. So, what's your next question?
Hey, hold on. My next question was, you never asked
me. Let me say something real fast. The brother host speaking, these brothers have been out here for about 20 minutes listening to Officer Sakawar talk about the atrocities that's being done to black people. Talking about the white man killing, it's cops killing brothers every week now. Every couple of days, they running them over with cars. And the only question he could come up with is not a solution.
You tell
not
him,
a solution,
baby.
But to talk about the
you
Bible being
that.
White. And when Sakawar come and bring up the image, he want to talk about imagery. As if we going to trust the white man and his imagery. When you have anything in the Renaissance,
Renaissance era. If you know what the Dark Ages was, that's when black people ruled Europe. Give me the archaeology, y'all. Give me the archaeology, the Dark Ages.
Get it straight,
the Dark Ages is when black people ruled Europe. You know why? That's why they called it the Dark Ages. And when they started painting them white bitches, that's what they called the Renaissance era. That's why this bastard is white. That's why this bastard is white. This bastard is white because you have white painters. Eddie, let me tell you something with history. Let me tell y'all something with history. When you have history, history is written by men. So when history is written by men, whoever's the authoritative with that pen, he's going to make himself the major important part of that story. That's why Jesus is white. But when you go into the Bible, he's not white. Now, these so-called Egyptologists, this is what you have. You have Uncle Keck. This is Uncle Keck from the Amun-Ra squad. Came all the way up here from Atlanta, Georgia, to do some dedication tomorrow against that false prophet, Dr. Ben. He was false too. He wasn't no different. Yeah, don't know why.
Oh, y'all hear that?
Don't know why. Now, let me tell you why. Now, I'll address that in a second. But what was Dr. Ben when he first started? He was a Jew. He got a bar mitzvah.